Hi, my name is Robert de Bok. I work for Adfinis, and today I'd like to show you a demo of three parts. The end goal is to show you Vault and dynamic secrets on MySQL, but in order to get there, we use Terraform to spin up infrastructure and Ansible to configure the environment. When that's done, we can play with Vault. So let's start with Terraform. Let me briefly walk through this code and show you. This code spins up two machines, three resources. One is a public key, an SSH key that I can use to log into the systems. Both machines, small, CentOS 8 in Amsterdam somewhere. One machine for Vault, one machine for MySQL, and it will show the IP of both instances. And that's where Ansible will pick up on. Let's first have a look if Terraform can deploy this. Terraform apply. This will take a minute, maybe just a little under a minute. So if we zoom in a bit, it shows you what it's going to do. It's going to make a MySQL machine, make a Vault machine, and make that SSH key and show the IP of Vault and MySQL. Yes, that's what I want. The machines are too small for a production environment. For a demo, it's good enough. We'll just have a simple setup. And spinning up these machines takes about 30, 40 seconds or so. They're then spun up, but not completely ready yet, because they need to be configured. There's nothing specifically on them. It's just plain CentOS. That's where we'll use Ansible for. We'll show that in a moment. Those machines are done. I have an IP. So that's the Terraform part. Let's switch to the Ansible part. So welcome again. My name is Robert de Bok, work for Adfinis. And today I'd like to show you the Ansible part of this Vault demo. The end goal is to play with Vault. We've just initialized the environment using Terraform. And now we'd like to configure the two machines we've created with Terraform using Ansible. So this is a playbook, Ansible language, or YAML. And basically what it does, it first makes sure that the machines exist and adds them to an inventory, it's an Ansible term, so that they can be worked with. After that, a couple of steps, actually one, happen on all machines. And then just on the MySQL machine, make sure MySQL is installed. And on the Vault machine, make sure Vault is installed. Vault requires an initialization, and that brings you a root token and unsealed keys. They're being saved so we can play with it. Let's have a look in if Ansible is able to configure these machines. This will take a while, so I'll probably fast forward the video. It's applying Terraform code again. Nothing has changed actually. It's adding those two hosts, and now it's going to run on these two hosts. So, see you in a couple of minutes. So Ansible's done. And as you can see, there's the summary shows on localhost it did two things. And that's basically the Terraform code to reapply it. And on the MySQL and Vault instances, it's changed more, which is completely fine. So we're now ready to start playing with Vault. See you in the next video. Hi, welcome. My name is Robert de Bok. I work for Adfinis, and today I'd like to show you Vault, and specifically the dynamic secrets in Vault. I've prepared an environment with two machines using Terraform. There's a Vault machine and a MySQL machine, and they've been configured using Ansible. So they're ready, a bit empty, but they're ready to be used. Let's first have a look at Vault. This is the machine, and in order to use Vault or the CLI of Vault, just the binary that's installed, we need to instruct Vault where to connect to. And for that, I need to export the IP of Vault, which is going to be used here. And for later on, we need to the IP for the MySQL server. I've already set those, so we don't need to worry about that. And in this case, we can just export the Vault adder. That's where Vault will connect to. If we look at status now of Volt, it should be running. It is. And it's initialized and it's not sealed. So perfect. We could use it if we wanted to. We do need to log into Volt once for this session. And I need a key for that, a root key. And that's saved here in Ansible, in the Ansible output. Here it is, a root token. And I can now paste that and I'm logged in. So I can use Volt or manage it or configure it if I want. So what we're going to do now is enable a database secrets engine. So that's done, but it doesn't really know about MySQL yet. We should tell Volt how to connect to MySQL. Bit of a long line, but let's try. Let's go over it. So it will write a database configuration called MySQL database. It uses a plugin MySQL and it connects to some username, some password at that IP address of the MySQL server. That username and password is listed here and they're extremely difficult to guess. So I should destroy this environment as soon as I can, but let's try, see if we can enable it. So this will actually try to connect to MySQL, see if it's able to, and it seems properly configured. It can connect. Now, next step is we need to create a role. That means someone can request credentials from MySQL, and when he or she does that, this command basically runs. So you could modify this as well to limit the scope or so. You see the validity of the tokens is typically an hour, but the maximum you could request is 24 hours. And this is the dynamic character of a secret like this one. Volt, I can request Volt, can I please access MySQL? Volt will configure those credentials, hand them over to me, and Volt will also go out and revoke those permissions. So in an hour time, if this demo takes much longer than an hour, it should stop working. Let's not aim for that, should be much, much shorter. Let's configure this this role. Good. So now I could ask Volt, can you please give me credentials for MySQL? Let's do that. And these are the credentials. So literally Volt just logged into MySQL, configured this username and password. You see them here. And I can use them now for an hour. So let's try that. In order to try that, I do need to install MySQL here. Should be quick, I hope. And now I can connect. Let's just type that. MySQL, the username. Ooh, that's a bit of scrolling, of course. Should have probably installed it sooner. Username is listed here. Copy. Password. Oh, I made a typo. No, that's good. Password. Let's copy that too. Here it is. And I should connect to a host. And in this case, I've saved that MySQL IP specifically for this. I'm connected. So Volt created this username and password, and it really does work. So that's good news. I could wait an hour now and see that Volt revokes it. From experience, I know that it will do it. So thanks for watching. Hope that gives you a bit of insight into the dynamic secrets of Volt and how easy it is to set up and easy to use. Goodbye.